Okay, magandang gabi po. Muli sa ating mga kababayan. Ayan, ladies and gentlemen, ngayon pong Biyernes na ito, special na Biyernes po ito. Okay, sa ating pong mga kababayan na nanonood po ngayon, lahat po tayo may mga kanya-kanyang challenges sa buhay. Walang perfectong buhay. I wish na meron. Pero wala po talaga. No? So, minsan, ang sabi nga ng mga matatanda, ang buhay parang gulong. No? Minsan nasa taas tayo, minsan maganda ang pasok ng finances, maganda yung relasyon natin. Minsan naman ay nasa baba tayo. May eto na yung pumapasok yung mga problema, hindi ka motivated sa trabaho mo. So, sometimes, kailangan po natin ng guidance. Kailangan natin ng life coach na tinatawag, no? Sa lalo na sa stress na meron tayo sa panahon ngayon, ano, 2024. Nagpandemya, ang mga negosyo, yung iba bumagsak, no? Ang inflation, walang tigil. Ayaw pong papigil ang inflation. Tataasan ang mga presyo. Pero ganyan pa man, we need to move. Hindi tayo dapat magsumuko, no? At para lalo tayong ma-motivate, minsan kailangan natin may nagagabay sa atin. Ladies and gentlemen, gusto ko lamang po sa inyong i-introduce ang ating susunod pong guest ngayon, a very special guest, dahil po marami po siyang natulungan, no, na maging successful sa buhay. Kumbaga, siya po yung rockstar pagdating sa motivation o pag-guide ng mga kababayan natin. Sama po natin ngayon si Coach Cherry para sa pag-usapan po natin yung kanyang libro na When the Heart Attacks, at pag-usapan pa yung mga ibang bagay na magmo-motivate sa atin. Ano? Isa po siya sa mga most followed transformation coach sa buong Asia. No? At siya po yung marami ng kumpanya rin na kumukuha sa kanya to motivate yung kanilang mga empleyado. Ladies and gentlemen, author, life coach, Miss Cherry Puwa Africa, welcome po dito sa KNB News.
Okay, thank you so much, Audrey, for inviting me. Ah.
Ayan, maraming salamat po sa pagpunta dito. No? Well, pag-usapan po natin, ano, kailan po kayo nagsimula maging life coach, ma'am?
Ako, madaming years ago, siguro 15 years ago na, no? I've been doing some life coaching. So, medyo matagal-tagal na rin. Early 30s, no? When I was in the early 20s, I was working in a multinational company in the Philippines. Mm-hmm. And then I moved out of the Philippines, no? Siguro for mga 14 years, I was out of the country. I live in Singapore, in Malaysia, and Thailand, no? Before mm-hmm. I went back home, no?
Well,
here.
Well, kailan ka nag-decide? Kasi, syempre, to be a life coach, siguro dapat yung experience mo rin sa buhay and naging matatag ka rin, ano? So, kailan mo to naisipan na it's time for me to influence a lot of people?
Na, bata pa lang ako, mahilig na ako mag-play ng teacher, Audrey, mm-hmm, no? So, I really wanted to help other people to listen more. And even nung high school pa lang, parate nagiging guidance counselor ako ng mga mm-hmm. kaibigan ko. So I thought, you know what? This is something that I'm very passionate about. Why don't we pour some kerosene, no? And just make this passion ignite.
Mm-hmm.
When I graduated from college, I went to a multinational, no, to sell mga products. Then I realized, hindi ito yung calling ko. Eh. Talaga yung calling ko is to work with people. And that's when I actually started to try and explore more mga different ways on how I could actually help people. And that's when I bumped into a system called Neuro-Linguistic Programming, NLP. No? Neuro-Linguistic mm-hmm. Programming is a system of achievement. Na kung gusto mo maging successful in your life, tatlong bagay lang ang pwede mo ma-control. Your mind, your language, and your behavior. If you're mm-hmm. able to actually learn the tools on how you could actually activate no, the best possible ways to succeed, then you could succeed, no, for a sustainable amount of time. So yun lang, pinag-aralan ko yung how the brain works, pinag-aralan ko yung, no, what's the best way to actually, you know, the language of success.
Mm-hmm.
And I've worked with a lot of people in companies, no, and even individuals, enough to actually see for myself some evidences of how the tools work, and it's been very fulfilling, no, in terms of my journey.
Mm-hmm. Well, ang isang tao na gusto ng pagbabago sa buhay niya ay lumalapit sa mga life coach kagaya ninyo. So ano po ba yung pinaka mahirap na sa isang tao na dealing with difficult emotions, lalong-lalo na base sa pag-aaral, ang Pilipinas po ay isa sa mga lahi, o Pilipino, isa sa mga lahi na napaka-emotional.
Mm-hmm.
No, sometimes tayo nagdedesisyon base sa ating emotions. So paano po 'yon? Paano niyo po hinahandle yung mga taong lumalapit sa inyo, mm-hmm, na talaga merong difficult emotion na kinakaharap?
Kung may difficult emotion sila at tumatambay itong emotion na to, no, sa body nila,
mm-hmm,
no, ibig sabihin yan, hindi nila nakikita yung resources that will actually help them to get out of that rut. They are stuck. Mm-hmm. Now, when you are stuck, you do not see the future. You do not see your goals. It's very blurry. All you're seeing are all your problems. So they come to a life coach who would actually help them see the resources, no? Inuusog-usog namin yung resources and tools para nakikita nila, no? Para nagkakaroon ng liwanag yung kanilang stuck state.
Mm-hmm.
So that, you know, ang emotions natin, it actually, ang emotions natin nagka-travel in our body. It's a dirty processing system sometimes. Na no matter how we try and sanitize these emotions, sabihin natin, magiging masaya ako today. Pag deep inside, may mga emotions, no? Like hostility or negativity or, mm-hmm, or depression or fear. Pag may mga tumatambay dyan, no matter how you actually try and cover it up, maglilikyan, tatagos yan, eh.
Mm-hmm.
In unconscious ways, lalabas yan. Maybe not in the words, if you're trying to prevent it from coming from your mouth, lalabas yan in the way your eyes will roll, di ba? In the attitude of your body,
body language,
mm-hmm, di ba? Makikita yan ng mga tao. Kasi non-verbals are more powerful than verbals, eh. Di ba? So mahirap. Then, you know, yung negative situation mo, nag-i-inspire yan, nag-a-attract yan na more negativity until you find yourself in a situation na parang dead end na.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when you try and access a partner, a sponsor, a coach, an awakener to try and make you find ano ba yung mga resources na pwede mong ipalit sa mga negative resources so that you could actually get out of it.
Mm-hmm. No? Sa mga nanonood po nating mga kababayan, mga nakikinig, ito nga, libreng life coach ngayong gabi, no? Paano ba dapat sinisimulan ang araw para maging positive yung buong maghapon mo?
Dapat siguro simulan ang araw with intention.
Mm-hmm.
No, a lot of times when you wake up, parang aksidente na lang, no? Kinukuha natin yung telephone natin, and then we allow whatever we see on social media to actually dictate our emotions or, mm-hmm, our state for the day. Hindi lang naman emotion yan, eh, pati mental,
mm-hmm,
pati physical state ang tawag natin dyan, no? Ang importante is when you wake up, we have that intention. How do we want to wake up? We want to wake up, for example, with gratitude or with power.
Mm-hmm.
Then we utilize some tools that's going to actually help us to assist to facilitate this states that we want to welcome so that when we wake up powerful in the morning, diba, we're able to actually determine how the day goes.
Kapag negative ang gising mo, ibosangot na yung mukha mo, no?
Oo.
Puro reklamo ka na. Minsan, nagtutuloy-tuloy, nahawa yung ibang mga activities mo, eh. Well, sa mga kababayan po natin, ano, na minsan lacking of motivation, yung masipag naman, pero minsan walang gana. So, paano ba natin mabilis lang na babaguhin ito, no?
May mga tao who needed a long time to motivate themselves. May mga tao naman nasa unconscious programming na nila, autopilot, default system na nila, na kapag, ano, no, kapag may mga negative emotions na dumarating, in an instant, in a heartbeat, kaya nilang palitan yan.
Mm-hmm.
So, ibig sabihin yan, siguro may level of emotional maturity ka na. Mm-hmm. It is a journey for everybody. Everybody's going his own journey, no? So, importante lang siguro to be more conscious. We have a technique which we call anchoring.
Mm-hmm.
kung kailangan mo, for example, ng motivation, na hawa, no, mag-iisip ka ng isang bagay, no, or isang tool that will actually anchor you on those most positive emotions that you need, eh. Diba? To some, I think to a lot of Filipinos, that will be prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? If you wanted to anchor on, kunari, gratitude, no, or to start your day right, you pray. It's an anchor kasi that actually helps you summon the necessary emotions. Mm-hmm. No? Iba-iba yung anchor natin. Iba naman, iniisip natin yung mga moments or memories natin that we were actually confident or powerful. Itatry natin i-access yan, no? These kinds of tools so that we're able to summon these most important emotions when we needed it most.
Mm-hmm.
Well, so may mga tools yan.
Okay. So sa mga tools na po ito, no? Sa mga Filipinos, pag-usapan po natin yung generation. Sabi nila, tayo yung generation natin mas matibay, mas tough. Yung pinaghirap, yung dinaanan natin mas mahirap kaysa dinaanan ng mga susunod na generation ngayon. Iba-iba rin po ba yung approach sa kung halimbawa ang client mo or ang nagpapa-guide sa iyo ay millennial o from Generation Z, Generation X? Iba-iba rin po ba ang approach?
Siyempre, iba-iba. Pero una sa lahat, magka-generation pa tayo. Tingin ko naman, mas bata ka sa akin. No? pero, di ba, iba-iba yung circumstances. Mm-hmm. No? My ancestors, no, mga parents ko, for example, they grew up in an industrial age, which means pag industrial age yan, madaling i-predict, no, yung may from step 1 to step 2 to step 3, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
And in this age, di ba, people don't change jobs, no, loyalty is very important. Iba yung values, obedience very important. Right now, when you look at the young people, what's most important to them is empowerment, fulfillment, all of these kinds of things. So, we cannot you know, raise leaders, no, future generation with the tools that we learned. We have to retool also as ancestors, as elders, so that we could actually shepherd them, no, and guide them, and hopefully provide light. No, meron silang ibang skills that we don't have. No, skills in technology, for example, di ba? AI, nakikita mo naman, no, it's everywhere right now. We don't know these things. We did not grow up with these things. Sila naman ang magtuturo sa atin.
So, exchange of ideas.
Exchange of ideas and actually the awareness that, you know, every generation has its own wisdom. This is the age of intention and wisdom. Di ba? Na iba-iba na yung mga wisdom. And a great leader is able to actually tap on the strengths of each generation and put it together and coordinate, no, these persevering resources so that you're able to journey together in a shared goal. So, importante yan.
Mm-hmm. Well, sa nakikita ko po sa mga, sa page ninyo, no, o sa website ninyo, may mga kilo-coach di kayo na maramihan, eh. No? Halimbawa, mga companies, ganyan. Iba po yung approach sa mga individual at iba rin yung approach sa maramihan. Ano po yung mas difficult?
Mas difficult? It depends on the situation. Like for example, ako, ang madalas ko gawin, 90% of what I do, I coach large organizations and big groups of people.
Mm-hmm.
Siyempre, iba yung skills that you need kasi meron din dyan stage management, public speaking skills. No matter how much tools or how great your tools are and how much positive your intentions are, kung if you cannot command, for example, the room, nobody will listen to you.
Mm-hmm.
So it requires a host of many other tools, no? Hindi lang siya yung kung nagko-coaching ka, di ba? Kailangan meron ka rin mga mechanisms, no? Mechanics. Pag nagka-one-on-one coaching ka naman, iba rin yung tool, no? Kasi you're talking to an individual, eh, no? So, mas personal yung approach, no? Mas, hindi mo na kailangan ng, you know, you do not need to actually have all of those speaking skills, no? But very, very important. I think, even in large groups, authenticity is very important in a coach. It's very important that you just don't do it because you are posturing or you're trying to to win the room. It's important that you also have a genuine heart, no, a generous heart, where you could actually, where you put yourself in the shoes of the other person and understand what the other person is going through or the group is going through and help through the process of coaching heal, hold the most important emotions so that they could go forward.
Okay, pinapanood ko po ngayon yung mga videos ninyo, no? At talagang ang galing dahil ang dami pero napapasunod nyo sila. And meron pa dyan yung nakikita ko para nakapaas sila. parang naglalakad
sa apoy.
Sa apoy. Mm-hmm. So how do you do that? Paano po 'yon?
We have a fire walking technique. Now, mm-hmm. It's part of our ultimate breakthrough tool. No, and it's something that I've learned from the United States, and I'm part of a global group of empowerment coaches. And what we do is, these are all just tools and symbolisms and metaphors, no? Na mm-hmm. pagka tumawid ka sa apoy, may fear eh. And this fear is very raw. Diba? But when you're able to actually cross through the fire in an instant, in a heartbeat, 6 seconds lang yan.
Mm-hmm.
And then pag natawid mo yan, that you will realize, teka lang, in a lot of the work that I do, medyo mas malaki yung fear kesa sa task. Di ba ganyan? Pag pinromote
tama,
ka
tama,
as a leader,
tama po kayo dun.
Mm-hmm. Pag pinromote ka as a leader, matatakot ka. Pero then you will realize, teka, yung task naman, hindi naman ganyan kalaki.
Mm-hmm.
And these are the disturbing inner voices, no, that we actually hear and we entertain and invite into our system na pinapatambay natin. These feelings of fear, guilt, diba? Feeling of we feel threatened, no? We feel na we are pushed out of our comfort zone. This causes anxiety, eh. Diba? And a lot of times, pag nasa state tayo ng anxiety, nasa state tayo ng fear, ang hirap makita ng goal.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we're looking at the past, we're looking at a messy middle. How could we even look at the future and expect it to be bright?
Mm-hmm. Yun nga po, no? Ang problem natin, minsan nagdududa tayo.
Pero
dito, ang nalakaran ko before yung mga ano naman, mga bubog.
So, ginagawa rin namin yan.
Sa morning show na experience.
Yes,
kayo atang nagdududa?
Oo, yes, naalala ko yan.
Oh, kayo po yun.
Naglakad ka sa bubong,
yes,
di ba?
Yes, kami po ni Diane Medina.
Yes, I remember
kayo
that.
Po yun.
Yes.
Tagal ko na nga sa PBB.
Kumusta ang experience mo naman sa paglalakad sa bubong?
Si Ma'am pala yun. Ano? Pinalakad kami ng actress na si Miss Diane Medina,
yes.
Ilustre. No? Naglakad kami noon. May video ako noon, nasa YouTube eh. Sa Audrey Gorseta YouTube. Yun yung unang-una kong in-upload sa YouTube. Ganun na po katagal yun.
Ano naman ang naramdaman mo nung naglakad ka?
Well, at first, natatakot ako. Kasi isang pagkakamali ko lang, maaring masugatan ka.
Yes.
Alam mo naman, everyday ginagamit natin ang ating paa para sa paglalakad. Ano? So, maapektuhan yung buong buhay mo. So, yung stitches, yun ang kinakatakot ko. Pag ito, bumiyak yung paa ko, tatahiin niya. Siyempre, matatakot ka doon, ano? Pero yun, ginaid mo kami,
yes.
Ni Diane. Sabi ko, bahala na. Sabi naman nila, safe. So, nagtiwala lang ako sa'yo. Naglakad po kami noon. Medyo mahaba-haba rin yung mga bubog na nilakaran namin noon. Mga 6 feet or 8 feet ata.
Yes.
So, ayun, nakatawid naman ako. Parang it's a relief nung natapos na. Pero in the middle, nung sabi ko, wala naman nangyayari sa paa ko. Medyo naging confident ka na in the middle.
Yes.
So, yung
iba-iba
yung
emotions, di ba? From the beginning to the middle up until the end. At the beginning, you get fear. Natatakot ka, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
And then so many stories. No, you are hallucinating with some of the invented stories in your mind. Yun nga, sabi mo, baka pwede kang the stitches, di ba? Mm-hmm. Paano na yan? Yung paa mo, importante yan. In the middle, parang nare-realize, so parang madali lang to, ah, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
But you continue to actually pay attention. A lot of times, you get hurt because you don't pay attention.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? We are distracted, we are disturbed by all of the other things, you know. And because we do not actually journey through that process with intention, we get hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Glass walking is a process where you are actually asked to be intentional. Kaya diba tinitignan mo yung bubog?
Mm-hmm.
How can it even happen? Isang pirasong bubog na nilakad mo, kunwari you're walking on the street barefoot at natamaan mm-hmm. mo yung bubog, meron kang dugo at may sugat ka.
Mm-hmm.
Pero that is actually a 50-pound glass bed that you walked on, Audrey, and mm-hmm. you did not even get hurt because you were focused and you were determined to finish it. Just like life,
mm-hmm.
when we pay attention, when we are focused, when we stay in the now, diba, we are hardly disturbed by all of the things, all of our fears.
Mm-hmm.
So, yun lang yun. Then at the end, diba may sense of fulfillment, kaya ko pala.
Yo.
That's when you discover the hidden resources. Eh. Kapag na-push ka into a situation na parang hindi mo kaya, and you continue to go through it, then you will realize, meron pala akong hidden resources na pag kinuha ko lang, hindi ko alam, no? Wala akong awareness, then you feel proud of yourself, you empower yourself, you become a better person.
Mm-hmm. Ang galing, ano? Well, na-experience nga po namin yun. Among sa 6 TV hosts that morning, kaming dalawa lang ni Diane Medina ang sumubok. Na
congratulations.
So, even yung mga staff eh, na-believe din sa amin dahil nirisk namin yun. Pero anyway, sabi nyo, minsan sa buhay, yung push ang kailangan natin. Well, sa generation ko, no, my life story, kaya ako na-push. Because early on in my life, 20 years old pa lang, nagkaroon na ako ng baby. No? So, single father ako for the longest time. Nagkaroon ako ng dalawang anak. So, in order to provide, lulunukin mo yung lahat ng hirap, sacrifices. Yun yung push na nakikita ko. And I remember, I'm Cherry, alam mo yung fake it until you make it. Tinatanggap ko lahat ng trabaho. Even though hindi ko alam. No? So, yung kaba na sinasabi mo kanina, one time, first time in my life, meron akong sinubukan. Nag-MC ako ng isang event. So, pag-MC ko ng event na yun, hindi ko alam kung paano mag-MC, pero nandito na yan eh. Kailangan ko ng resources eh. Financial resources. Yung kabang yun, yung bago ko lumabas ng stage, sa backstage, just imagine, madilim sa backstage, yung liwanag na nagsaseparate doon, yung liwanag ng mga, ng studio, no? Kabadong kabado ka. Pero since nandito na ako, eto na ako, gawin ko na yung best ko. So, I think much tougher yung mga taong naka-experience ng ganun, instead dun sa mga other generation na nandyan ang mommy at daddy to support, ano man yung mangyari sa buhay nila, if they fail sa career na path na tinake nila, may sasalo eh. Is it magkaibang version ng challenges yung ganun?
I think definitely yes, no? Adversity, grit is very important. Look at where you are right now, mm-hmm. Diba? And when you look back, nasabi ka ni Steve Jobs, when you look back and then you connect the dots, it just makes perfect sense. Mm-hmm. But in the moment when you are stepping on that dot, it's painful and a lot of people will whine, will moan, will rant, diba? And will give up. But people who continue to actually get through that, no? And just carry on, kahit na minsan hindi mo alam saan ka pupunta, you just, alam mo, trust the system, tiwala lang, or mm-hmm. tiwala lang sa sarili mo, and then you'll just get surprised. I think one of the greatest and the most beautiful things in life is when you allow yourself to get surprised. Eh. Mm-hmm. Maganda yung feeling ng surprise. Eh. Diba? Surprise adds on, eh, na parang yung emotion ng joy, kapag may joy plus surprise, iba yung feeling yan, talagang mm-hmm. super happy yan. So, mm-hmm. I think it's important that in order for us to actually, or for you, like what you've gone through in your life, to get to your goal, when alien and beastly emotions, no, visit you, ito yung mga emotions na hindi mo maintindihan, nakakatakot, no, nakaka-cause ng anxiety, when you're able to tame it, when you're able to regulate your emotions and just get through it, when you're able to frame a difficult situation with the right story, and then you visualize success, darating ka doon. I think human strength is so much more powerful than we give it credit for. Mm-hmm. And our journey here on earth is actually finding that, you know, that strength, no, that we never thought existed. Mm-hmm. And just allow ourselves to be surprised by the circumstances we allow ourselves to get in. I think that is wonderful. And we should push ourselves, no, in situations that allow us to be a better person. We owe that to ourselves and to, I guess, the great person who mm-hmm. has actually created us in his own image. I call it our original state. Mm-hmm. Our original state is meant to be great.
Ayan.
But we forget it sometimes.
Anyway, Ma'am Cherry, well, anong year to, Sir Johnny? Ano yung nakalagay na year dyan? Kung sobrang tagal na to, no? Papakita ko. Well, eto po yung video na yun. Nahanap ni Sir Johnny. Ayan po tayo, ma'am. That was, I think, 12 years ago or 9 years ago. Yan, pinaglakad po ako ni Ma'am Cherry sa bubog.
Natakot ka pa, nag-hesitate.
Yes, yan. Hindi po ako tumitingin sa bubog. Ayan. Diba? Yan ang talagang life coach. Inaalalayan ka sa paglalakad sa bubog. Diba? May audio yan. Pwede palagyan ng audio. Sir John. Yan, tinatakot pa ako ng mga staff ng PTV.
Naririnig ko pa yung talagang sound ng bubog, no?
Opo. Yan, may mga nagugulat pa. Yan, oh, iba pa yung pangalan ng show namin before, Good Morning Boss pa. So, this was si dating Pangulong Noynoy Aquino pa yung presidente niya.
Yan si Dayan, di ba?
Yan si Dayan. Relax na relax si Dayan. Po yung experience ko with Ma'am Cherry. Palakpakan po natin, mahirap yun eh. Mahirap po yun.
Pero di ba, Audrey, tingnan mo, how many years ago was that? Di mo pa na, hindi mo nakakalimutan.
Hindi ko nakakalimutan.
And just like a firewalk, you never forget a firewalk. You just need to do it once. Mm-hmm. No? But the lesson that sticks with you will stay with you for a very long time. Yan tiyatawag natin na anchor. Eh. Mm-hmm. In situations, for example, where you fear fear again, when you feel fear, di ba, halongkatin mo lang yung memory mo. Eh. Tapos meron isang memory na mag-stick sa'yo na, kung kaya ko dati, kaya ko na dapat ngayon, lalo pa ngayon, because I'm now stronger, no, even better. So, if we will just remember, no, and pick the lessons from the past, and then inspire ourselves, no, dun sa future state na gusto natin makuha, mabilis na tumawid sa isang present time na medyo magulo minsan, diba? So, yun ang purpose. Eh. The purpose of the past is to give us lessons. That's the gift of the past. Mm-hmm.
Pero no, ang ganda po nun, no, motivated ka. Ang dami mong pinagdaanan, ang dami mong nafe-feel na energy, na positive. Pero hindi laging ganun eh. May mga araw na gigising tayo, wala tayo sa mood, hindi tayo motivated. Paano natin, how to keep our motivation? Alam mo yun, parang may burning alam mo yung motivation na talagang matindi. Sa minsan, medyo may kakulangan ito.
I think number one is if you could actually come up with a routine, no? Sometimes rituals in those routine, na gagawin mo siya araw-araw, no? And discipline yourself to do that so that you will constantly wake up to a desired state. No? Whatever that is, if you wanted to wake up being motivated, meron ka dapat ginagawang routine, whether it is to exercise, to read a book, diba? To actually pray. You create that routine every day for 21 days, even beyond, until it becomes an unconscious pattern. Mm-hmm. Pag unconscious pattern na siya, alam mo na gagawin mo siya kahit hindi mo siya iniisip. Eh. But that takes time. Mm-hmm. Diba? Yun yung unconscious. Talagang parang gumising ka. Talagang for some reason, you do not even say, I want to be motivated. You're just motivated. Mm-hmm. But as in everything, it requires practice. Practice does not just, you know, make perfect. Practice makes permanent. Diba? You keep on practicing for many days until it's just unconscious. Then, hindi na kailangan i-motivate sarili mo kasi motivated ka na eh.
Parang basketball po yan, ano? Kung everyday nagpa-practice ka, parang muscle memory na lang siya.
Yes, muscle memory. Correct.
Okay. Now, marami sa atin are dealing with stress. Yung environment toxic, no? Kahit sa opisina naman siguro, may mga office politics, may mga marites. No? Siyempre, pinoprotektahan natin yung ating integrity. At minsan, we're dealing with such a load of responsibilities, no? Paano ba how to deal with stress? In short, paano ba natin i-handle ito dapat?
Una sa lahat, stress ba is good or bad, diba? That's mm-hmm. also, it also depends. So there is healthy stress. Kasi kung wala naman tayong stress, dipetics lang tayo.
Slack lang ang
buhay. Then we do not, actually then become a better person, diba? Mm-hmm. Pero kung the stress naman pushes us to a state na parang freeze, fight, or flight, ayaw rin natin yan, di ba? So it's important na alam natin kung ano yung healthy stress, no, that we have. It's overwhelmed, for example. When we feel overwhelmed, positive ba yan o negative? Pwede yan negative, pwede yan positive. Di ba? We do not want to be underwhelmed by life. Mm-hmm. Di ba? We want to wake up being overwhelmed with life in a positive way. Pero ngang word dyan eh, nasa book yan eh, ang tawag dyan, numinous. Numinous means I am overwhelmed and I am stressed, but I am fascinated by life. No? You're able to see, you know, you're able to put stress and overwhelm in a positive context, and then you're able to give it the right energy. And here's the surprise. The moment you give it a good point of view and the right energy, mag-iibang behavior mo about stress.
Ano po yung difference nun?
No, kasi usually pag iniisip mo, na-stress ka, nadadown ka, no, nai-infect ka ng bad energy, parang tinatamad ka na, ayaw mo na gawin, nagagalit ka. And when these are the emotions, no, that you allow your body and your spirit to be disturbed with, your performance will be affected. No, so, sa trabaho, pag stress ka, di ang bilis mo magalit. Pag stress ka, nagre-react ka kaagad, di ka na nag-iisip. Pero when you pause, no, na-stress ka, na-overwhelm ka, but you pause, you know, give it just a few seconds of intention or reflection, and you don't react, but you really just respond. You choose the best way to respond. Then you will realize, teka lang ha, parang, ang ganda ng behavior ko ha. Diba? And people will look at you, how to be you? No, na-stress ka, pero ang ganda naman ng response mo.
Oh, well, grace under pressure.
Yes, grace. I love that word. It's also here in this book. Yung grace under pressure. Grace can be negative, eh. Yeah? Pero if you give yourself the grace period, the grace, di ba may grace period tayo? 5 seconds lang, 10 seconds lang, no? For me to actually just recover from that blow, from that alien emotion, and then really just, you know, and invite yourself to, ano, what is this telling me? And then you respond with grace and elegance. That makes you a great leader. Eh?
So, importante yung sinabi mo, no? Pause for a minute. So, you're dealing with too much stress. Hihinto ka muna dito. And then rediscover yourself.
Yes. Correct. Pero may problema tayo. When you go to the company and you needed a minute's time to recover, some people cannot wait for that minute. No? I think it's also important, no? For leaders, the message for leaders is you actually allow yourself to actually wait. There are people who needed to actually just look for the time to recover and you wait for that insight. So it's important, kaya nga ang change, especially in companies, they're best, you know, executed when it is a culture, eh? When it is a group, no, changing, and not just one person, two people. You allow the environment to support the change process, no? Mas nagiging mabilis ang change.
Okay, pag-usapan po natin, Ma'am Cherry, itong when the heart attacks. Ayan. Hindi po ito yung sakit, ha? Iba pong heart attack po ito. So, kindly explain, ano po yung naging inspiration sa inyo at ano po yung content ng librong yan?
First, yung title niya, When the Heart Attacks, Everything Falls into Place. This really is about the heart brain. Meron tayong tatlong brains, tatlong utak. Akala natin kasi utak natin nandito eh. No? This is called our head brain. Pero we have two other brains. We have the heart brain and we have the gut brain. The head brain is responsible for creativity, for logic, for reasoning. The heart brain is responsible for our relationships, values, no? And the gut brain is responsible for our courage. This book is all about what the heart can feel, and it can feel so many emotions. No, meron tayong top 10 emotions. Pinaka-importante, gawin nating bida sa buhay natin itong top 10 emotions na to. Pero pag mahirap siyang i-access, meron din tayong maraming granular emotions, no, in between emotions na pwede natin kunin sa araw-araw at madali lang siyang invite. And this is what the book is all about. This features 60 emotions. No,
60 emotions.
60 emotions. Some of them, mga words that are not in English and not in Tagalog, no, in different cultures. Minsan kasi may mga words na hindi mo ma-translate. Like kilig, paano mo siya i-translate in English? So meron tayong mga versions of kilig that's coming from different cultures. And we try and bring it here. And I explained how, what this means to different cultures. And when you're able to know the words, when these emotions come to you, you're able to explain your emotions, you're able to at least, you know, regulate the emotion, eh. Diba? Or invite the emotion, eh. So this is what this book is all about.
Alright, ma'am. Malaki po bang may tutulong pagdating naman sa leadership ng content ng libro.
This book is written for leaders, no? Mm-hmm. Self leaders, if you want to lead yourself as a parent, no, or as a student, as a youth leader, it's also for leaders in organizations, no? Even senior leaders, no? Malaki siya kasi parati iniisip natin, Audrey, when you want to be a great leader, 'di ba? Your decisions must be devoid of emotions. Meron 'di ba nagsasabi na masyado ka kasi naging emotional eh, kaya hindi maganda 'yung decision mo, kaya 'yung decision mo weak. This book is trying to say, hey, you know, it doesn't mean that if you actually put emotions in your decisions that you are a weak leader. 'Di ba? There are useless emotions, but there are also useful emotions. So the awareness of what the useful emotion that you need to put in a particular situation even energizes whatever thing, no, that mm-hmm. you need to achieve eh. Pero pag walang emotion, di ba tayo robot eh, di ba? We're not AIs, we're human beings. God gave us emotions. These are our resources. Importante, kasama natin siya, kaakbay natin siya sa journey natin. Mm-hmm. Because we're humans.
Alright, ano po yung mga attributes ng isang good leader?
Marami. Mm-hmm. No, I think one of the biggest attributes of a great leader is compassion.
Compassion. May malasakit.
May malasakit, no? Mm-hmm. And when you talk about compassion, there's the word empathy, right? Mm-hmm. Una sa lahat, there's sympathy, which means you commiserate, you know the feeling of the other person. Mm-hmm. Empathy means I understand your feeling. I will walk in your shoes, no? And understand you. Pero the greatest is compassion. I understand your feeling, I walk into your emotions, and I suffer. I suffer with you. What does that mean, no? I give you my energy, I give you my skill, I give you my time. That mm-hmm. is compassion, eh. You get hurt in the process of that exchange, but you still do it. Mm-hmm. And leaders need compassion. You need to understand what your people are going through and suffer with them, no? Mm-hmm. And when you are together, brotherhood, no? During these times of crisis, you forge that unity, mas mabilis yung ma-achieve yung goal ninyo.
Yeah. Well, sana mabigay tayo ng ganyang libro, no, sa ating mga politiko. Kailangan
sana, no?
kailangan ng mga politiko natin yan, yung compassion, hindi yung pang-TV lang. Anyway, sa mga kababayan po natin, lalo na yung mga nasa abroad, no? Pwede ko pong hawakan yung libro. Paano po natin, paano po nila mabibili itong librong to at saan po ito mabibili?
Publisher ko dyan is called World Stage International. Pwede kayong pumunta sa Facebook, sa LinkedIn, World Stage International, no? Sa IG, or they could also contact me, Coach mm-hmm. Cherry Africa. So contact me through Facebook, through IG, through LinkedIn. Ang website namin is cherryafrica.com or worldstageinternational.com.ph.
Ayan, pinapakita po namin ngayon, ito po yung mga libro, no? So ito rin po yung mga phone number at ayan din po yung inyong email address. Ayan. So sa mga interesado po, again, sa mga kababayan natin, sometimes may mga natatago tayong talent na hindi lumalabas because natatakot tayo. No? Take it from me. Ako po isang mahiyaing individual. Mahiyain lamang po ako, pero dahil sa circumstances na dumating sa buhay ko, at a very young age, napilitan ako na kumilos, and nakarating ako kung saan man ako narating. At kung wala yon, wala yung mga circumstances o mga problema na dumating sa akin, maaring relax lang ang buhay. And sometimes sa mga Pilipino, ganyan eh. Basta may nasasandalan. Ito yung katotohanan, Ma'am Cherry. Sa isang pamilya, halimbawa mahirap na pamilya, isa dyan yung nakapagtapos ng pag-aaral o isa dyan yung sinuwerte makapag-abroad. Ang nangyayari, yung nasa abroad, magpo-provide sa kanilang family. Makakapagpatayo ng bahay, lahat ng mga kapatid, kahit nag-asawa na, titira doon sa loob ng bahay. May sinasandalan. At yung sometimes, yung sinasandalan, sila yung mga nagbibigay ng sakripisyo. So, ang ating kailangang ma-motivate sa ating mga Pilipino, lahat kumilos, lahat magsakripisyo for the betterment of our families, of our communities, at syempre, all in all, sa ating bansa. No? Well, gaano kahalaga din yung education, as hindi ka lang basta motivator, eh. Kayo rin po ay educator in a way. So, gaano kahalaga rin na mag-zero in tayo, mag-focus din tayo sa education.
I think it's very important, mm-hmm. di ba? Education teaches us the concepts, the skills, no? And it's a formal system where there is a teacher that we look up to and is actually the source of our, you know, the education or the content, no? Pero education is not only gathered from the classroom, di ba? Life is also a big classroom. And when you have the right perspective na pag tuwing pumupunta ka sa isang crisis in life, if you ask yourself, what is this crisis teaching me? Isn't that education?
Ayun, tama. Yeah. Dapat ano yun, education ang treatment natin sa problema. Ano yung makukuha ko dito? Ano yung matututunan ko dito?
Diba?
Okay. Well, may mga lumalabas sa social media ngayon eh, yung sinasabi nila na diploma o diskarte. No? So, for some, kalokohan yun. At marami rin na hindi na nag-aaral dahil sa mga ganyang nababasa sa social media. Pinaniniwalaan yung mga ibang influencers na detrimental sa kanilang career, sa professional career. Ano pong masasabi niyo doon?
I think, ano ba yung pinamapili mo ako sa diploma and discount?
Hindi, well, may mga influencers po kasi na makapag-content lang, ano?
Oh.
And sometimes, nakaka-apekto sila sa buhay na mga wala pa masyadong experience sa buhay. So, sino ba dapat yung piliin nating coach o yung mga influencer na pinapanood natin?
Yes, that's very important, no? I think it's very important that you research, no? Kung ano yung background ng influencer na yan. No, mm-hmm. Sometimes it's really just content for the sake of content or mm-hmm. borrowed content. Yung wisdom is coming from other people, pero wala naman actually yung wisdom that's coming from the person himself. So it's very important that you exercise due diligence and vet naman the person you wanted to inspire. You know, you wanted to generate that inspiration from. When, you know, success is reproducible. Eh. You could reproduce success. You could look at the life, no, and the content of a person and follow and copy whatever, no, code that person has, and then try it in your life, and then add your own style, add your own energy, add your own belief system, and make it your own. Mm-hmm. Di ba lahat naman yan eh, wala naman dyan originally 100% yours, no? We are all products of, you know, patchwork quilt yan eh, of all the people that we've learned from. May kanya-kanya, our parents, di ba, kung ano tinuro sa atin eh.
Different situation.
Yes. So it's important. It's very important. You vet the people that you wanted to model from. Pag-aralan mo sila, kunin mo kung ano yung matututunan mo, and put it and apply it in your life and make it your own original.
Alright. Alam nyo, ma'am, ito yung traditional, ano? Kayo po yung nag-author ng book.
Yes.
Pero, well, the way to go ngayon 2024 in the future is social media. Meron din po ba kayong mga TikTok na nag-a-advise kayo,
nag-coach kayo? Meron, meron. Nag-TikTok na rin ako ngayon kasi nag-try ako mag-adapt to the younger generation. No? Mm-hmm. Cherry Africa, Coach Cherry Africa.
Ayan, sa TikTok, nandun din po si Coach Cherry. Again, finally, sa inyo pong, ang inyo pong advice sa ating mga kababayan at ang inyo pong libro, please invite them na bumili po nito.
Yes, I am very happy, no, my team and I, this is actually a book with years of research, no, from working with people. A lot of the stories there came from our actual original interactions with people,
oh,
no, lalo
ng
people
okay.
in companies.
Mm-hmm.
So sinulat namin diyan, binigyan namin ng perspective, hinugot namin yung mga importanteng emotion, no, that allowed the person to actually solve his problem, get through a crisis and or achieve a certain goal. So it's a work of love, and what we do is to try and give this to people in working in companies, no, especially to the leaders, to guide them with the right emotions to energize and motivate a group. So I invite, no, all the leaders in organizations, no, to bring up and to elevate the consciousness, no, of your people and your team, and go and read the book. It's very practical, very easy to read. You could just choose an emotion for one day, apply it. May worksheets din dyan,
mm-hmm.
so that they could do every day with their teammates, no, so that they could actually apply and learn it together.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Again, ito po ay sinisimulan ko ng basahin. Nasa tabi po ito ng kama ko, no? Binigyan ako last week ni Ma'am Cherry. I'm encouraging everyone, lalo na yung mga followers po ng KNB News at ng PTV, na subukan niyo po ito. Walang mawawala. No, minsan, yung takot eh. Yun yung dapat nating labanan sa buhay natin. Yung fear. Yung fear na napakaliit lang naman. No? So, kung kaya ko, na lumakad sa mga bubog, yung mga kinush ni Ma'am Cherry, lumakad pa sa nagbabagang apoy, no? Kaya nyo rin po yan. Again, when the heart attacks, everything falls into place by Ma'am Cherry Puwa Africa. Maraming salamat
po
sa pagbisita
much.
Sa amin. Ayan. Again, ang ating pong KNB News ay sa bayang napapakinggan sa Radyo Pilipino Paris. Again, good evening po sa mga kababayan natin sa Europa. Ngayon na rin po sa Winners Life Hong Kong. Sir Lakay, Winners Life President, Sir Lakay, nanonood po ngayon. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. Sir Dick Villanueva, Love Visual Corporation, Ma'am Lalaine, and of course, PARC President, Ms. Isa De Los Santos. Maraming salamat po. Sa ngalan po ni Sir Johnny Esteban Jr. at Sir Virgilio Belivestra, at Sir Steve Esteban, ako po si Audrey Gorizeta at sumayin niyo po ang KNB News. Happy weekend po sa lahat. God bless.